The view of the town of Otsuchi stops you in your tracks. Everywhere you look, the improbable, the unsalvageable. Much of the town of 16,000 reduced to this. First the earthquake and tsunami, then a gas explosion followed, which burned through what was left. In the path of destruction, the city hall. After the earthquake, the mayor rushed out of the building and set up a command post right in front of City Hall. As the tsunami was approaching, though, then he and members of his government evacuated to the second floor. The tsunami, though, came as high as that clock. It killed the mayor, and more than half of this town's leaders are missing. Even as they grieve for their own, city workers do what they can to help victims, the living bearing the burden of picking up what's left. Half of the city's residents are either dead, missing, or homeless. All of the town's history washed away, except for sparse mementos collected from the wreckage. The government they rely on barely there, moving more slowly than nearly anywhere in the tsunami zone. Victims left to plead for help from national leaders visiting the small town.
I believe that the people who are living in this weather prefecture, based on this miserable weather situation, but they recover without that.
You believe it in your heart?
I believe.
Easier said than done, says Ayano Okuba. I lost everything, she says, her grandparents and her home. There's nothing left in her hometown and no one to lead the rebuilding. Even though I like Otsuchi, she says, I can't come back here. You can see the survivors making the choice, leave, or like Akita Sasaki, stay. He lost his parents, his house, his job, and most of his city. I have a lot of friends afraid to stay in Otsuchi, he says, but I won't leave. A city trying to mend, the tools to get it done, as broken as the terrain. Kyung Lah, CNN, Otsuchi, Japan.